So the star args notation appears in two places. It appears in the definition of a function, and it can appear in a function call. In the definition of a function, what it means is this function can take any number of arguments, and they should all be joined up into a tuple called args. So if the call to the function looked like this, something of f, 1, 2, 3, then 1, 2, 3 would be bound up into a tuple and assigned to args. So within the body of something, args is equal to the tuple 1, 2, 3. And then this part here means take that tuple and apply it not as a single argument, but rather unpack it and apply it to all those arguments. So function of star args is equivalent to writing function of 1, 2, 3. So it's just a way of packing and unpacking arguments with respect to function calls. Now, one thing I want you to notice here is that we used a function as a variable, as a parameter, or something that's passed into another function. We're using the property of Python that functions are first-class objects, just like integers and lists and everything else. Functions are objects that you can pass around. That's very powerful, because that way we can control both what happens and when it happens. The idea here is that we want to call this function, but we want to delay calling of the function until we've already started the clock. We want it to happen between the time we start the clock and the time we end the clock. And in order to do that, if we try to write something like this, timed call of the result of calling zebra puzzle, then time call wouldn't work. It'd be too late, because what we pass to time call would be the result of zebra puzzle. We don't want to pass the result. We want to pass the function that we're going to call and be able to delay execution of that function until the right time, until we're ready to set the clock. And so functions allow us to do that, to delay execution until later.